let everyone the peace of the Lord, in reverence to the word of God, I would like everyone to stand up so we can read. We're gonna read 2 Luke. Luke 13. Luke 13. 11, 12, and 13. Luke 13, 11, 12, 13. And it says the word of God. And behold, there was a woman who had a spirit of infirmity for 18 years and was bent over and could in no way rise up herself. But when Jesus saw her, he called her and said to her, "Woman, you're loosed from your infirmity." And he sat and he laid his hand on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. God, we glorify you. We thank you everything for this moment, because you have called us one more time to be in this place, because we need your blessings, your grace, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for everything, for your word, for your spirit, and we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. The brothers may be seated. The Bible says that Jesus, he was in a church. He was in synagogue, in the temple. And it was a day just like this, a day of Saturday. And Saturday speaks of day of relax. And Jesus says, those who are sad, tormented, come to me and we'll find rest for yourself. So today we came to church, to the house of God, and we know that God is, and what he wants you is to give us rest for ourselves, because Jesus is bigger than Saturday. He's the God of Saturdays. And the word of God says, on that day, on the day that Jesus was present, and all time that Jesus is present, in a service, in a reunion, in the middle of many people, of his disciples, always there was a blessing of God in favor of those who need it in all parts. There was, you could see the presence of God in the miracle that will happen by him. And tonight in the service that God is present, it's not gonna be different. God tonight wants to operate in the life of a woman, especially. And there was a woman. And this woman, she had a spirit of infirmity. She was sick. That woman, she didn't have a disease, a physical disease. She was sick. It was her spiritual. It was a spiritual problem. She was sick her son was sick. That's why Jesus said, "You'll find rest in the day that I'll give you rest." She had a spirit of infirmity, and the spirit was with her for a long time, and it used to make her sad for a long time. The word of God says 18 years. 18 years seeking and getting sad. And we can say that we could believe that someone that's 18 years tired, she for sure have looked for anyways for to get rid of it, of the infirmity that she had, that used to be with her. But when the problem it's of spirit, there's only one doctor that can solve. It's the doctor Jesus Christ. That's why he's here tonight. That's why he's present tonight here. Because he wants to operate. He wants to save you. He wants to save you from everything. He wants a miracle. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory given to God. Hallelujah. Bless the name. Amen. Church, I'll talk to you and I'll show you my presence. My presence is real between you guys. Those who could feel it, the touch of my hands in your lives, I'll tell you myself. I know in this place, because my wings have protected you guys. Because for me, you are my shields. Because I've taken care of you guys. I know that some of you have been through difficult times, have been sick. But my sons, everything is for the glory of Jesus Christ. Because I'm not gonna let anything would happen to you, and will let you get out of my presence. Keep in my presence and in my fellowship, and I'll continue talking to you. Amen. This is our God. Hallelujah. Glory have been given to God. Hallelujah. My brother and my sister, especially. The Bible says that the woman she used to walk not so straight. She wasn't really able to get straight. She could only walk like that, curved. And the Bible says the way of life is up. She you couldn't look up. And the Bible says that your help will come from God that made up the heaven. She was sick. Probably she tried to find many ways to get rid of it. She used to walk. But she walked curved. Here, we could say, especially a person that knows the way. She was walking. And there's a song that says, "No more for the reason." So she used to walk in the way that was the way of God, in a rational way. She used to walk looking down, looking for the man, looking for the ground, for the dirt. She used to walk the way that she used to think. And that was why she was sick. A weight that was a big way on top of her that wouldn't let her straight herself up. My mom once told me, "My son, would people that is born curved die born, and when it's burned, the ashes hurts." And the Father, that's God, he says, "It's everything that is curved, I'll do straight. I'll make it straight." God, he straightened everything up. He can fix the man. The woman, she had a problem with her, like, the way she used to see. You know that the problem she had was how she used to get straight. She couldn't get straight in the right way. And many times we are just like that. We are in our reason, the way that we think. We try to fix ourselves. We try to be or do something right. Write something that we think that is right only God, but we are not able to. Do you know why we can't? Because it's not from what happens that you, my sister especially, you're not gonna be saved. It's not for that. It doesn't come from the miracles, but it comes from God, from the Savior. Because everyone has sins. And they all have sins from God. And the salary from the sins is that. All my time, I used to walk to the dad, but that was God to send me life. And now I live. She used to walk to the dad, her dad, just able to. But God, on that day, he saw her. My sister. Jesus is here tonight to save you. And he saw you. Why am I saying that it's you? Because he told all these people here that he saw you tonight. The eyes of God is looking at you. And I'll tell you, my sister. After this, I'll tell you why you're my sister. Jesus saw, looked at that woman. That she was curved. And there was no way that she could get herself straight. I'll tell you guys something. Me, there was no way that I could get to straighten myself up. And Jesus fixing me until now. And that's what he wanna do to you. He wanna fix you. He wanna make you walk the right way. In the presence of God. And the word of God says, Jesus saw the woman. And call her. Jesus calling you tonight. If Jesus called a woman, it's because she was kind of far from him. If she was close to her, next to Jesus, he wouldn't need to call her. But there was a distance between them. And Jesus says, let's make this distance kind of short. He called her so she could be next to him. My sister, don't go far from God. Don't go far from Jesus. Because he wants to be next to you. The name of Jesus is Emmanuel. God, he wants to be present in your life 24 hours. Every single time. That's why he calls you. Jesus calls you tonight so you could be next to him. Because if you're next to him, with him, the blessings that you need, he will give you. And that's what Jesus did tonight. He called her and said, woman, you're free from your sickness. He called her so she could be free from everything, because she was kind of close. If you want to read verse 16, and Jesus says that the infirmity, it was just like a jail. And that kind of jail over there, there was only one person that could free you. And the person says, if the sons free you, truly you'll be free for life. Jesus called on the woman so he could fix her, so he could turn her free, so he could glorify the name of God. You're free from your family. And after that, God do something interesting. He put his hand on top of her, a laying of hands. When Lord stood his life for me, I was poor, I was lost, without God, without Jesus, but God stood his hand up on top of me, and he's doing that tonight. He's standing up his hand on top of you, his right hand, so it could give you blessings, so the Spirit of God could be in your life, so he could fix everything that's wrong with you. He could straighten you up so you could walk in the revelation of God, the right path. And you know what happened, my brother, my sister? When she was cured and she got fixed, I really like this woman, because in the Bible says there are many cures. Your brother got blessed and he left. He didn't even say hi or thank you. Not even a see you later. 10 lepers, 10 cured. Only one came back to thank God. And there was one woman. There was only one woman. And that woman stayed. And the word of Jesus says that she stayed And she thanked God for everything. She understood one thing tonight. That from that time on, she would not walk without Jesus anymore. She couldn't walk without the presence of the Holy Spirit. The woman had something that many people don't have. You know what it is? Gratitude. She got her blessing, and she stayed next to her, next to Jesus, couldn't find him. She understood that she was part of that church, of the synagogue, of the temple. She was part of the people that Jesus was Christ. So she stayed, and she was going to find Jesus. And Jesus used to ask, Jesus, why did you do that on Saturday? Jesus asked, it's because this woman, she's a daughter of Abraham. And Jesus always blesses the son of Jesus. Son of Abraham have two kinds of sons. The ones from Israel, that is natural, and from the descendants of Abraham. And there's the other kind of sons, just like us, that gives the power, that is our brothers, because we believe in God. And the woman, she had faith. That's why she will call us daughter of Abraham. Because if you believe, you're a son and daughter of Abraham. And if you're a son of Abraham, you're gonna get, what do you get? You're gonna, at the hands, you're gonna get a land that flows honey, a place in the heaven, a place in eternity. Daughter of Abraham, you can go back in peace, because tonight God gave you the free will, and he gave you everything that you could need to glorify his name. Let's play another song. Amen. The church will stand at this time. Lord showed a lady my sister. And for a long time ago, she's been having something in her life, a difficulty, and it's not letting her walk right, walk the right way, in the path that Jesus have for her life. And Jesus revealed this thing that she got in her is that because she's sad and she's trying to get rid of this. She's trying to get rid of this prison, of this feeling. But this feeling, it is in her heart. And every time that she tries to take this out, in the way that she understands, trying to make her own justice and even getting away from Lord, it's only getting worse. And that's not good for her spiritual life. But she's been trying, and she tried in the wrong way. But tonight, she's here with all this in her mind, in her head, in her heart. She's here in the presence of God. She's here. And Jesus has been operating in her life, and he's giving a blessing and a cure in her life. And Jesus said, "Woman, you are free from your sickness." Jesus showed a brother that he got here kind of hungry. He needed food. When people are hungry, it's because they have been for some time without eating. And Jesus said, the bread of life, right? And we will limit God, right? And when we don't have the word of God, Jesus, that's what happens. We actually start showing some needs. And Jesus shows that he prepared for this brother some food. That is him. And the Bible says it's a plenty of food. And he will get rid of all your necessities. But you need to come here and get this. You need to understand that you need Jesus. When in the past, in Egypt, every day they would have food. Who would stay hot inside of their house wouldn't have the food, but they would have to go and try to find and seek for it. And when we come to the house of God, we always have plenty of food for us. If you got this plenty of food and bring it to your family, you're gonna have a lot of food for you and your family. And at this moment, he couldn't see all this. For the moment, the first song was sang. This man actually started smelling the food of God. The food is good. You can actually recognize by the smell. And the Bible says that we have to smell, to feel the smell of God. And the church gets together, and the smell of the food is the smell of Jesus that everyone noticed here. When we plead for the blood of Jesus, we can feel the presence of God here. We can feel his love. And he could see that. And he ate all that. And he was good after this. And he's a brother too. He's here. He's part of the table of God. God, we thank you for everything. We thank you for this time that we're here pleading. We thank you for all the cures, for everything, for our salvations. We thank you and we glorify the name of Jesus because you're good. And we thank you for your grace, for the love, grace, for everything. Please confirm everything. people from the church, get your hand on top of everyone here. So Dick got cured and saved. We played the name of Jesus. We say that the grace of Jesus, eternal love, the in the name of Jesus, amen. The brothers may be seated. This is the end of the service. If you that need a pray, if you need us to explain something, just stand your hand up and we'll come to you and we'll pray for you. We remind you guys that we have the early dawn tomorrow at 10 and we have the service tonight at 7:30. Is the Lord everyone?